all over the country, leaders are now talking about what has to happen to move the nation forward. Tonight, 7 Eyewitness News reporter Ed Riley talks with some community leaders for their perspective on what it's going to take to see some real change out there.
We are the city of good neighbors. We live with each other. We should be able to coexist peacefully between police and the residents.
Another group protested in downtown Buffalo outside the Holding Center. It was peaceful and included Voice Buffalo and a large contingent from Buffalo's religious community. They are calling for the formation of a rapid response team comprised of community and faith leaders.
Before officers use force, they call out the rapid response team, and we have the ability to de-escalate.
Buffalo police already had a policy of community outreach. But after meeting with protesters on Tuesday, Police Commissioner Byron Lockwood said more discussions will be happening shortly.
I understand what they're saying. And here in Buffalo, there need to be some changes done.
And take specific action based on what we're hearing from the community.
Buffalo Common Council Majority Leader David Rivera said he feels the protesters' pain.
The race continues to influence how law enforcement treats people of African American descent.
Rivera said the Common Council will be seeking a way to restore trust in police.
I think it's just by sitting down with them, having a conversation with them, listening to them.
Cecil Foster has written multiple books on race and is considered a leading Canadian intellectual on the subject. He is a professor with UB's African American Studies program. Foster believes a public acknowledgement and apology for past wrongdoings can go a long way towards healing.
With an apology, we are often making a commitment that never again would we do it. An apology means nothing if you were to apologize and to go out and do the same thing all over again.
That needs to be followed up with concrete and visible signs of reform.
Now is the moment, now is the time to come to terms with what is wrong and to fix it. And I think that's what we really need to start thinking about seriously.
The Buffalo Community Police Advisory Board is also looking at this issue. And later this week, they plan to release a list of recommendations that will hopefully prevent unrest like this from happening in the future. In downtown Buffalo, Ed Riley, 7 Eyewitness News.
Also happening tonight, a warning from